Well, anyways,
Maybe you can just give like 10 or 20 second introduction and then you can start with your questions.
Yeah, I'm just saying about myself something. Like, my name is SambitPhD. I just finished my master's from TU Darmstadt, Germany. Mm-hmm. And my transcripts are yet not ready, like the final transcript, but I graduated already, you can say. The official process is going on to dematriculate me.
So it's the master's, right?
Yeah, I completed my master's, yeah.
And how long was it? 1.5 or 2 years?
In Germany, it was I took it like 3 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Because we have a mandatory internship that we have to complete in between them. Mm-hmm. Search for a thesis, search for an internship. Like, searching for an internship takes 2 months. Searching for a thesis takes 2 months. Mm-hmm. You have to, it's already 3 years. You cannot help it.
Yeah. Because I had also one Skype call, if you have seen that in the YouTube. So that he was applying for PhD in TU Delft, but he did his master's in Germany. I don't remember the name of the university. So he also said the same thing, like he extended it to 3 years and it's convenient. Like,
yeah, in general, the average completion rate in Germany is like 3 years, 2 months for every student, not only like international students, but also the national German students also, they also complete around 3 years.
And you also have advantage that you don't spend much, right? Like, I mean, as compared to Netherlands and other places, you don't pay that much in the tuition fees. Like, it's almost free, right? Like the studying in Germany.
Yeah, my university, it was totally free, I will say.
Yeah. I mean, 99% of the cases, it's like that, whatever I know. Like,
yeah, if you study in government funded university, so the study is free. Like, there is no tuition fees, only there is a semester fees every 6 months. That is also very minimal, like 270 euros or something. That also covers the traveling expenses in the entire state. Mm-hmm. So it's actually free, you can say. You cannot call it that they charge something. So right now I am actually a bit confused about what I will do next. Like, I will go for a job, or I will go for a PhD.
Okay.
My research area, what I did in my master thesis and my internship and all, is actually a little bit narrowed down to a particular field.
Mm-hmm.
Software defined networking, 5G networks, and also like P4. And a little bit of machine learning and stuff. And while I was actually looking for some research jobs, not actually a PhD position,
mm-hmm.
while going through this research job in Google, I found that like there is a very interesting position in TU Delft. Like, I was focusing on the kind of opportunity, or you can say kind of profile that I want to work. Mm-hmm. And when I find this profile, it's like a 95% match what I want to work and what I had worked. Like,
okay, that's nice. I mean, if you can feel that match, then obviously that is for you. Like,
yeah, exactly. That is what I felt after going through the requirements of this position and stuff.
Mm-hmm. So it's like a research engineer, or what is the name of the position? Because generally I know people after masters, either you can choose for PhD or you can go for a research engineer or something like that, because the salary that you get as a research engineer is a little bit more than what you get as a PhD. So it's completely different, and that's for people who don't want to go into this dedicated like 4 years PhD, because not everyone is sure of going there. I mean, that's like a commitment, so it's not for everyone, so it's up to you. Like,
I understand that. And actually the research area, the field area, has some expansion that I know. I have some ideas that I can incorporate. That's why I was also, frankly, I was also looking for some jobs in Deutsche Telekom. There are some startup companies working in the in research areas, what I wanted to do. But this particular position, they specifically have this kind of requirements, which I have in mind that if I want to work, I work there. So that's why I practically, honestly, I did not have the idea to do a PhD. Like you have said in your video that you accidentally started your PhD or something.
Yeah. Have you seen that video? Like what was that? I mean, that video is in this screen now. That's why I'm seeing there. Like, that was like, how do you say? Like,
the position is actually mentioned as PhD. It's not a research position.
Oh, okay.
That's why.
I mean, if they mention it as PhD, then it must be PhD, like.
It is written actually, PhD, 5G resilience and stuff.
Okay. I mean, normally, have you seen the PhD? There was a video on TU-Delft PhD interview. Someone was asking, that person was from Germany. Like he did his master's in Germany and he had an interview in TU-Delft. So he was asking the procedure, like, I mean, I also applied for one interview in TU-Delft, but then many other things happened. That's like a story. So it's, I mean, it depends, because as you said, you can feel 95% maths. Then I think it will be easier for you to prove that thing when you give the interview and the presentation. So what exactly do you want to know, like the interview process or?
Yeah, the basically I have an idea how the PhD selection goes on.
Mm-hmm.
I have been working with my department from last 2 years as well.
Okay.
So basically, you have to give your master thesis presentation again.
Yeah, most places they ask for it again.
And what is after that? Like when I send, because they ask for my CV, my cover mm-hmm. letter, like research.
Yeah. Transcript. The motivation letter or the cover letter, whatever.
And the transcript. So these documents are enough, or do I need to have a recommendation from my professor?
Normally they ask for recommendation. I don't know if it is mentioned there, but most places they ask. Like what happens is, because here you don't give a letter, you just give the, I mean, they don't ask for recommendation, they ask for referees, like the person who they might contact later. Because I have been to 5-6 interviews in Netherlands, and I've seen in all places what they do is like first round interviews always in Skype. And in that interview, sometimes they ask to present your thesis. Sometimes they do it in the campus in the second round. And in that, they also sometimes ask to write a one-pager research proposal for the position that you're applying. So that, I think you must be having idea on that because you are already involved in that process. So, yeah, but you asked something, right? I mean,
yeah, I asked, like, is the same procedure in the Netherlands as, or there is some other criteria to fulfill or something like that, right?
Yeah, okay. So in the second round, this either if you present it before, then you don't present, otherwise you present. But normally, sometimes they have two presentations if they have both. So one will be your thesis, master thesis, and another will be for this one pager, the research proposal. And that is expected like 2 to 3 slides or maybe max 4 slides. It should be like very short just to know how you approach it. That's the thing.
Yeah, that is not like a form thing. If that is the idea, it can change a little bit or be formed a little bit later.
You have
to make the attendees believe in your idea, and you have to impress them with your idea. That's all.
Yeah. And for the CGPA, I think, I mean, I, based on my limited experience, I think in some universities in Germany, that is given a very high priority. But in Netherlands, even if you go to TU-Delft, whatever I know, if you are above, because in Netherlands, the grading is very strict. So considering the Dutch way of grading, if you are above 7 or 7.5, that is more than sufficient. It's not like everyone should be above 8. Because here, I don't know about Germany, but here the grading is very conservative, like the Dutch way of grading. Like between 7 and 8, they're max. Almost everyone is between 7 and 8. And so,
well, specifically in the TU, like in the technical universities, you have a grading system. That was actually my second question. So what is the criteria of the CGPA? And you said like 7 and 8. Maybe that is the Dutch system of grading, but here, you know, the German grading is like 1 to 5, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So maybe you can see something equivalent like that, maybe 75%, because in master programs also, they ask for 7.5 when abroad bachelors, when people come from abroad. So what I think it is, because in my case, my CGPA in master's was like overall 7.2 or 7.3, I don't remember. But still, I did not feel that mattered a lot in most, because the TU-Delft interview that happened was like, it was with a company like Eden, that's a payment gateway company. So they had their approval, but they also wanted to know what Aden says about the profile of the selected candidates. And then they invited the people for the second round interview. Okay. So sometimes in these kind of big projects, your company persons also, you need to meet them again for the interview. That happens in some cases, not every time. So that is another thing. And I think rest are the, I covered everything. Like,
most probably then I have a percentage, if I calculate in a percentage, it's like between 79 or 78%.
Oh, then it should not be, I mean, it should not worry that much about the CGPA. Like, I mean, for them, I think the more important is your thesis than the CGPA. Like, they don't care. Like,
yeah, in thesis, I got 1.7, that is equivalent to almost, I guess, more than 85%, 90%.
Oh, that's great. I mean, that's really great. Like, considering what you get here, if you get here 8, that is like a distinction. So,
yeah, it's a distinction. Like, if you get a thesis in the range of 1, like, there is in the range of 1, 1.0, 1.3, 1.7. So, I got 1.7. So it's also kind of a very good grade considered here in Germany as well. Okay, so that question is done. And the next question was like,